السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Abbas, son of Ali, عليه السلام, was born from Umm al-Banin, the mother of the sons. His brothers were Abdullah ibn Ali, Ja'far ibn Ali, and Uthman ibn Ali. When he was born, his father Imam Ali alayhi salam kissed his arms and cried, for he knew the outcomes of his future. History tells us that when Imam Ali alayhi salam was on his deathbed, he put Imam al-Hussein's hand into the hand of Abul Fadl alayhi salam as a trust. Imam Hussein alayhi salam and Abul Fadl were very close. Narrations tell us that when Abul Fadl was born, it was Imam al-Hussein who read the Adhan and Iqama in the ear of Abul Fadl alayhi salam. Whilst he was in the arms of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, Abul Fadl smiled and raised his arms. Imam Hussein began to cry. In early childhood, Abbas alayhi salam would follow Imam al-Hussein like a shadow. If Imam Hussein looked thirsty, Abbas would rush to bring him water. If Imam Hussein seemed hot, Abbas would fan him with the hem of his cloak. At the Battle of Safin in the 34th year after Hijrah, Abbas was only 8 years old. Imam Hussein was fighting in the battlefield. When Abbas saw an enemy soldier approaching Imam Hussein alayhi salam from behind, he took a sword and rushed into the battlefield and killed the enemy. At the same time, crying out in a loud voice, "How can anyone dare attack my Mawla when I am alive?" He continued to fight, maintaining his position behind Imam Hussein. Muawiyah saw this and asked, "Who is that boy?" When he was told he was Abbas, son of Ali alayhi salam, he said, "By God, no one can fight like that at that age except a son of Ali ibn Abi Talib." Abbas grew up to be a tall and handsome man. He was so tall that when he sat on a horse, his feet touched the ground. He was so handsome that he was known as Qamar Bani Hashim, the moon of the family of Hashim. Just before the Imam al-Hussein left Medina, Umm al-Banin summoned all of her four sons and said to them, "My sons, you must remember that whilst I love all of you, Imam al-Hussein is your master. If Imam or his sisters or his children get injured or hurt while you are still alive, I will never forgive you." There were tears in Abbas's eyes as he promised his mother that he and his brothers would lay down their lives for Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam and his children. Abul Fadl is known as the spine of Imam al-Hussein's army and seen as the guardian of the camp. His valiant efforts for trying to find water when the means to the end of his life. Abul Fadl was no stranger to war. In the Battle of Safin, Abbas fought and killed many of the enemy. He wore his father's clothes, so people mistook him for Imam Ali himself, alayhi salam. Later, Imam Ali came onto the battlefield and people were confused. "Who is that wearing your clothes?" Imam Ali introduced his son Abbas by saying, "He is Abbas, the moon of the Hashimites." Imam Zain al-Abidin says, "May Allah have mercy upon my uncle Abbas. He preferred his brother to himself. He did well and sacrificed himself for this brother until he lost his two hands. Thus, instead of his two hands, Allah will give him two wings with which he will fly with the angels in paradise, much like Ja'far al-Tayyar alayhi salam in the sight of Allah. The blessed, the exalted Al-Abbas alayhi salam enjoys a peculiar rank for which all the shaheeds will be hopeful for if they had its like on the Day of Judgment." Imam As-Sadiq alayhi salam says, "My uncle Al-Abbas was clear-sighted and steadfastly faithful. He fought along with his brother Al-Hussein, did very well and was martyred. Salams be upon Abul Fadl al-Abbas, son of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. He preferred his brother to himself, supplied himself with opportunities of today for rewards of tomorrow, sacrificed himself for his brother, protected himself, hurried for fetching him water, and his two hands were cut off for this. May Allah curse his killers, Yazid ibn al-Raqad and Hukaym ibn al-Tufail al-Ta'i." والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.